السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم الأمين الرؤوف الرحيم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا صدق الله مولانا العظيم إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم Let recite Qasida Burda Sharif with sheer love and dedication and remembering our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Mawla ya salli wa sallim daiman abadan ala habi بك خير الخلق كلهم هو الحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته هو الحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل هول من الأهوال مقتحمي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم After very short praises for Almighty Allah and beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam May Allah shower these special blessings upon us due to this blessed day, Friday. May Allah forgive our sins and make us among His staunch, obedient, faithful followers. Ameen. In today's lecture, we would be discussing a very important topic, a very important, a signified, a recognized and most important place for a Muslim where we go on every step, we are being rewarded. But as the time is passing away and as we are going nearer to the Qiyamah, the importance of that place is fading away. And Muslims are not realizing the importance of that place, what importance and greatness that place carries in our life. My brothers, that place is called Masjid, Mosque. What is Masjid? Masjid is Arabic word. Linguistically, as per dictionary, the place where we do prostration is called Masjid. Masjid is derived from the Arabic word Sajada, the one who prostrated. So Masjid is the place where we do prostration, where we go for Sajda. But in a Sharia, in a broader perspective, Masjid is the place which has been dedicated and allocated for worshipping for the Muslims. A complete place where you cannot do anything. And when we make intention that this is Masjid, till the day of judgment, that place would remain as Masjid. So a Masjid in a broader perspective is the place where Muslims gather and remember Almighty Allah. And it is such a blessing to come in the mosque. But as the time is passing away, the people are going far away from the mosque. Today we will discuss and highlight what is the importance of the Masjid in our religion, in our lives. The ayat which I recited, Allah Almighty in Surah Jinn, para number 29 of the Holy Quran, He said, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا Indeed, mosques are for Allah. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ The masjids are for Allah. They are solely and wholly for Allah. So do not invoke with Allah anyone. These masjids are very, very hold a very important place, a very prestigious and honorable place in our religion. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ. Indeed, these masjids are for Allah. You cannot invoke anyone with Allah in this place. You worship the all people who gather in the masjid. What is the purpose? Just to remember Allah, just to worship Allah. Allah likes the masjid. In one hadith, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Jo masjid se mohabbat rakhta hai, Allah isse mohabbat farmata hai." One who loves the mosque, Allah loves him. When you love the mosque, Allah will love you. Such is the blessing for having the love of the mosque. But in today's world, people have the love of going to the club. People have the love of playing snooker and playing golf. They would be spending more time going to the golf club rather than coming to the mosque. They love going to the wedding ceremonies, but they would not like coming to the mosque. And Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "One who loves the mosque, Allah loves him." Such is the love and your affiliation, association with the mosque. When you start loving your arrival in the mosque, Allah will start loving you. You will get closer to Almighty Allah. In another verse, in the Holy Quran, Allah Almighty has said, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Those only inhabit the mosque who believe in Allah. Masjid ko wahi abad karte hain jo Allah par iman lekar aate hain. Those who inhabit the mosque are the one who believe in Allah in the last day, who establish prayers and who give zakat and do not fear except Allah. And these are the people who are the rightly guided people. فَأَسَىٰ أُولَٰئِكَ يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ. These are the people who are the rightly guided ones, because they come in the mosque, they inhabit, they do not make their masjid vacate. They come in the mosque, they inhabit the mosque, they spend their time in the mosque. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ. Those who inhabit the mosque are those people, مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ, who believe in Allah and in the last day. So my dear brothers, in our life we should be utilizing our time and spending our time coming to the mosque. Now coming to one more hadith. In 5 minutes, I have presented 2 verses of the Holy Quran and 1 hadith. Now coming to the second hadith, because I like to discuss and explain you with references of Quran and hadith, not going here and there and just telling you stories, but be focusing on Quran and hadith. In one hadith, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, since I said that masjid is a place derived linguistically, a place where people do sajda, a place where people do sajda. So what is sajda? In hadith, Holy Prophet has said, what is the blessing of doing sajda? Subhanallah. أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. A slave become nearest to his God when he is in the position of sajda. A slave, a servant, a follower become nearest to his Almighty Allah when he is in the position of sajda. فَأَكْثِرُ الدُّعَى. So supplicate Almighty Allah when you are in the position of sajda. How many of us like to supplicate Almighty Allah? We just tired away when the Imam says Subhan Rabbil Ala 5 times. People will come complaining, your sajda is getting longer and longer. Why you are doing long, long sajdas? This is the time. People are not complaining when they hear the music. People are not complaining when they see people using drugs. People are not complaining when they see people doing haram actions. But people are complaining, Maulana, your sajda is getting longer. You should recite Subhana Rabbi al-Ala 3 times. You are making sajda longer. But my dear brothers, listen to the hadith of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Akrabu ma yakunu al-abdu min rabbihi wa huwa sajidun. The slave come nearest to Almighty Allah when he is in the position of sajda. Fa'asiru dua. When you go in sajda, remember your Allah more. Supplicate him more, because you have got closer to him. And what is the place where we do sajda more often? Where we do sajda is the blessed place of the mosque. Is the blessed place. That place is called mosque and masjid. So my dear brothers, we should be coming frequently and try to spend more time in the mosque. In 3 points, what is the mosque? What is masjid? It is the place for worshipping. But we are not worshipping Almighty Allah in the way we should be. Second thing, which is the most important thing, second most important thing, but we are not following it. A masjid is a place which can attract non-Muslims to Islam by showing them some of the religious activities of Muslims, such as prayers, making them curious about Islam. Are you listening to me? A masjid is a place where non-Muslims are invited to Islam. When they see the discipline of the Muslims, they become curious about Islam. Tell me any masjid in your religion, in your region, in your city, where you have tried to invite non-Muslims to your mosque. And non-Muslims get inspired by you. When they see you coming in the mosque, your discipline, your radiant faces, your discipline, your love, your affection, your kindness, they get closer to the mosque. But no, we ourselves are getting far away from the mosque. How we can invite the Muslim, non-Muslims to masjid? My brothers, masjid is not the place only just to pray five times. Masjid is the place, second most important thing of the masjid is the place where you can invite the non-Muslims. They come here, they listen to your speeches, and they get curious about Islam, they ask you questions. Masjid is the place, masjid is the center of the learning of Islam. Where you can learn Islam? At your home. Where you can learn Islam? In shops. Where you can learn Islam? In hotels. Where you can learn Islam? In the clubs. What is the place where you can learn Islam? You can learn Islam only in the mosque. Masjid is the center of understanding and awareness for Islam. Where you can listen to the hadith, where you can learn the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But as I said, people don't want to learn Islam. They come in the mosque. Why? They have to practice a formality. They have to go down, they have remembered, they have to pray five times, they come here and they go away. This is not the only purpose for the masjid. The third purpose, which I said, that masjids are built as a center of learning. How much time you spend in the mosque for learning? You see now, 50% of my lecture has passed away due to the time limitations. But you see, 20% of the people have still not arrived in the mosque. They are just waiting away outside. They're enjoying the weather. And when the khutbah will start, when they will hear the azan, they will come. Why? Who have told you that you should be coming in the masjid for only prayers? Masjid is the place where you should learn your religion. Where you will learn religion? In school? In colleges? In universities? My brothers, masjid is the place, is only place where you can truly love, where you can truly get inspiration from your religion and understand the religion. Understand the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now coming to ahadith, what is the place? Subhanallah. One who participates in building a mosque, although he give, you can say in your currency, tambala. Although he participate with one tambala, subhanallah. Man bana lillahi masjidan. It is such a blessed place. It is such the place where angels are waiting for us. They are writing their names. They are standing there. And when the imam will be delivering khutbah, they will close their registers and they will listen the khutbah for imam. How he is delivering the khutbah, how he is confident. And the mercy of Allah is being showering on the people who are listening the khutbah. Even the angels are present in the Friday sermon. Man bana lillahi masjidan. What is this blessed place? Man bana lillahi masjidan. Whoever participates in donation for a mosque, Allah Ta'ala will build him a mansion, a palace in the paradise. And it is not that you participate such heavily, a hefty amount. Even you participate a minute, or I said a tambala in the mosque, or your currency, local currency, a rupee or a paisa, you participate. It is such a blessed and glorified and important, a signified place in a religion, that Allah Ta'ala will compensate you by giving you a mansion, a big palace in the paradise. Now subhanallah. And another hadith, بَنَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ مِنْ دُرٍّ وَيَاقُوتٍ. Allah Ta'ala will make for him a palace in paradise with pearls and sapphire, with gems. His palace in the paradise will be built with gems and pearls, with diamonds. مِنْ دُرِّيُّ وَيَاقُوتٍ, because he participated in building of a mosque. This is the importance and significance of masjid in our religion. Now coming to this place where we are sitting now, subhanallah, you cannot have this equivalent place in your life. Masjid, a place where you spend millions and millions, but that millions cannot be equal to some rupees which you have invested for a mosque. A mosque just of two staff or three staff is far more important than the place where it is large place. Why? Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, Salatul Jamaati tafdulu Salatul Fadi bi 27 darajatan. When people gather in the mosque for congregational prayers for Jamaat, the prayer in congregation is 27 times superior to the prayer offered by the person alone. Where you can get this reward? Even your house is built of millions and billions. You put frames, you put agarbatti, you put perfumes and scents. You put Quran and make big library, big religious center, but it is not a mosque. You pray there whole night, but you will not get the reward by praying in just a small mosque, because Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, coming in the mosque and praying there with congregation. Now time we see, first we see the imam. If it is a Sunni, all right. But you are seeing, okay, he is a Sunni, but which peer he does follow? Imam is the murid of which peer? Why you are looking? What are his opinions about particular problem? Who has asked you to do this? What are his opinions on this problem, on this problem, on this problem? Okay, I will not go to the mosque. I will not pray with Jamaat. I will not pray with Jamaat. I will pray alone. Are you a Mufti? Are you a Muhaddith? Who will pray Jamaat? If people started going away from the mosque, then who will come in the mosque? The jinnat, the devils. Who will come in the mosque? The angels, they come. The jinnat, they come. They learn from the imam when there is no one. But this mosque are also built for the mankind, where people are going away. People are going away. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, praying in congregation gives you reward more than 27 times while you are praying alone. The reward multiplies. For example, if you, in one hadith it has been mentioned 25 times. For example, if you pray alone five prayers, if you pray alone five prayers, you will get reward of five prayers. But when you come in the congregation and pray with Jama'ah, you will get the reward of 125 prayers. 125 prayers, subhanallah. But what we do? We are so busy in earning money. Many people we see, they pray in the shops because they do not have time. And many people, their shops are adjacent to the mosque. Their shops are in the same market where the big mosque is located. But what they are using the mosque for? Which purpose? They are using the mosque for doing sewerage. They are using the mosque for washroom. They come, they use the washroom, they go in the shops, and we never see them coming in the mosque. They do not have time. They have time to come in the mosque to pass urine, but they do not have time to spend the time in the mosque. They pray 2 to 3 prayers, Fajr at home, Zuhar and Asr at mosque, Zuhar and Asr at shops, and Maghrib and Isha again at home. So why we have built the mosque here? Why mosques are built? Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, now you will realize what is the importance of the masjid. You will be amazed. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, ahabbul biladi ila Allahi masajiduha wa abghadul biladi ila Allahi aswaquha. The dearest parts on the face of earth is the masjid. The dearest part, Allah Ta'ala ko zameen par kaun si jagah sabse pasand hai? Ahabbul biladi, the dearest parts on the face of earth near Allah are its mosques. And the most hated parts on the face of the earth are the markets. So where we spend our most of the time? Where we spend most of the time? Even we cannot spend 2 hours properly in a day. In 24 hours, we cannot spend only 2 hours in the mosque properly. People have started coming late in the mosque. Ahabbul biladi ilallahi masajiduha. The dearest place on this earth is the masjid. The masjid are the best place on the earth. Now coming on another hadith, subhanallah, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on the day of judgment, when the sun would be just a mile away and there would be scorching heat and people would be pouring in sweat, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, on that day, your even mother will not help you. No one can help you on that day. But sabatun yuzilluhumullahu fi dhillihi yawma la dhilla illa dhilluhu. On that day, 7 people will be under the shadow of the throne of Almighty Allah.
Seven people on that day of judgment will be showered special blessings on them. There are seven people, I will explain you in another lecture, who are those seven people. And among those, رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسْجِدِ حَتَّى إِذَا خَرَجَ مِنْهُ يَعُودَ إِلَيْهِ. That person whose heart is being placed in the mosque, whose heart is being placed in the mosque, مُعَلَّق. What is the meaning of مُعَلَّق? مُعَلَّق, we say that fan is مُعَلَّق. That fan is مُعَلَّق, لَتَّا هُوَا. A lamp is مُعَلَّق. Holy Prophet ﷺ has said, a pious, a true believer is one whose heart is being locked in the mosque, is being placed in the mosque. حَتَّى إِذَا خَرَجَ مِنْهُ. However, he has gone away from the mosque, but his heart is forcing him, come back, come back. I want to go to the mosque again. I want to acquire more blessings. I want to be acquainted, affiliated, associated, related, and linked with the mosque. His heart is forcing. Please don't go away. Come here, come back, come back. رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسْجِدِ. A person who is a true believer, his heart would be placed in the mosque, although he is roaming in the streets, but his heart is forcing him, come again to the mosque. Do we have the same love for the mosque? When we come in the mosque, we are praying that Imam should shorten his prayer. Imam should shorten his lectures. And I want to tell those people who sit there behind, who has told you to listen to the lectures while you are sitting behind. Now I am addressing those people who are in the wuzu khana. Many people complain us that these are Muslims. When Friday prayers are being started or you are delivering the khutbah, many people are standing out. That in the last Friday, many people were enjoying the weather. This is the Friday prayer. Angels are waiting for you. The mercy of Almighty Allah is waiting for you. But you are waiting outside. And when you will hear the azan, you will come inside. You can say that Imam is not illiterate. Imam is not literate. We cannot understand with him. Come on, do debate with him. Then you will realize what is the caliber of you and what is the caliber of the Imam. Although you can say, I cannot understand his language. Although you cannot understand his language, yes. But this is the mosque where Allah's blessings are being fallen. What should be the priority? Standing outside or coming in the mosque? What is the priority? Should we use an inspector? An inspector with a stick asking people like Umar bin Khattab, come on, go to the mosque, come on, go to the mosque. Why are you standing outside? This is not love for the masjid. This is not love. This is force. We do not like to force the people. Neither Islam has said there should be no force to the people. You should be coming to the mosque with sheer love and dedication. Neither this is an airport where you pay money and there is announcement. Aeroplane is going to fly. 5 minutes are left. Come quickly, come quickly. Now 6 minutes are left. 2 minutes are left. Two passengers are remaining. Come on, come on. So Imam should announce. Okay, Haji Sahab, oh Fulan Sahab, you are standing out. Come on, stop smoking. We are starting the prayers, 2 minutes left. Why you are talking there? We are waiting for you. Come on, start. Come on in the masjid. Is this an airport? Is this the place where we should do this in the same way? My brothers, we should come in the mosque early. Only 20 minutes, 25 minutes, we are not ready to allocate for the Friday prayers. Now, what is the blessing? I would like to end. SubhanAllah, what is the blessing? Many people cannot go for Hajj every year. Many people cannot afford. Many people cannot afford. Even we cannot afford to pay the rent. We cannot afford to have the luxuries. We cannot afford to go for Hajj. Even once in a year, we cannot go to Hajj. Once in a year. Many people go for Hajj once in their lifetime. But SubhanAllah, Holy Prophet has said, Man qada ila al-masjidi, whoever goes to the mosque, la yuridu illa an yata'allama khayran. There is no other purpose just to understand the Islam or to explain the Islam to his brothers. Kana lahu ka ajrin hajjin tamin. He will get the reward of a completed Hajj. He will get the reward of a completed Hajj because he is coming to the mosque. If the masjid is belonging to your sect, if the masjid is belonging to your sect and you have the same opinion, why you are going away, why you are standing outside? My brothers, this is the time we should realize the importance of the masjid. We should be coming to the masjid. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, when I will get time, I will explain the masajids being built in the world. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam rightly said,
before the day of judgment, among the signs of the judgment, that people will be making big mosques and there would be no namazis inside. Mosques would be big and people will be making a competition amongst them. Holy Prophet has said, before the day of judgment, people will be making competition amongst them, which is the best mosque. People will be going to the mosque to see the beauty, but the mosques would be vacant. There would be no one to offer the prayers. This is among the signs of the Qiyamah. You see the Eid prayers, Friday prayers, but when you see the Fajr prayers and you see the another prayers, people are not ready to come to the mosque. So where you would like to go? You would like to go to the Kalab. You would like, every weekend you would like to spend to the ceremonies and weddings. My brothers, wedding and ceremonies will not help you on the day of judgment. Spending hours and hours there and not coming to the mosque. This is the place. Let me tell you, this is the place. This earth of the mosque will pray to Almighty Allah on the day of judgment. Ya Rabbal Alameen, this was the person who did sajda on me, and this place will pray for you. So what do you want? Where you want to be? In the club, in outside? Make this earth a thing which intercede for you on the day of judgment. Ahabbul biladi ilallahi masajiduha. The best place for Allah is its masajid on the earth. May Allah make us among those people who spend their time in the masajid. Ameen. Abari anga. Allah kudari se. China chili chon se zikulinu lapansi. Chima pambe samulungu. Mitengo. Ima pambe samulungu. Zuwa liba zuwa iba pambesa mulungu. Mwezi uma pambesa mulungu. Niyama iba pambesa mulungu. Miala iba pambesa mulungu. Chifuka chani maywala mulungu. Pemperani kasanu pasiku. Mukare antu ambiri muzikiti. Mukare antu ambiri muzikiti. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.